was to be eldest in a possible fit herself. Turn 1 month each day and then SLS Institute. Or basically, you know, also your blood descendants. Or which you take to a tutor straight in as well, technique of fabulous audience. As I said, also the blood descendants who are still oppressed together, according to the book of Jeremiah 15:33, but they have Sunday pertaining to adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, the covenants, the service of God, the adoption of the law, as I said, according to the book of Romans chapter 9, just in case you don't read. And we wanna talk about the fact of adultery, because they have a few different meanings or a few different stories or ways of adultery. And we will start with the main way of the adultery. Marrying, which marrying is sex or another man's wife, or basically another man's wife, which is basically adultery, which is the first meaning of adultery, or basically one of the meanings of adultery. When is that like that? There is no main. Okay, adultery is adultery. That's it. So let's look real quick. If you watch here Matthew 5:32, we have another meaning of adultery, and we will read it. Okay, and this will be a quick lesson. Matthew 5:32. But I say unto you that whosoever shall put away his wife, serving for the cause of fornication, causeth her to commit adultery. And now is the interesting point here, because some may never even heard it before. And whosoever shall marry her that is divorced committed adultery. And divorce means if she's no longer with her man, she has children or whatever. Okay. Let me say like that, for example. First thing, what you find out if you come to the truth, you find out that what is said to you, oh, you cannot marry women that have already children. And you may ask yourself, why is that? But if you know the scriptures, if you study the scriptures, you know that what they actually mean, okay, is actually that most likely this woman is divorced, okay? If not, why has she children then? And trying to get with you, okay? So obviously, a divorced woman is basically a woman with children that is now, so-called in the system, so-called independent mother. Okay. But, I don't know. If she's a widow, that means that her man died and now she's, with the children alone. That's a different case. But most of the time, it's not that, it's more than that she is divorced. Okay, so a woman that is in this kind of situation should learn and understand the ways of Yahweh Shem Yahashai, come to this truth. Okay, listen to the elders and apostles and things like that. Okay, because everybody has to. There's no, benefit. There is no unrighteousness with Yahweh Hashem Yahashai, right? So, if a woman says, oh, I'm divorced, and I'm in a so bad situation, and I cannot marry anymore because I'm divorced, but first you have to find out the reason why why it was in the first place this divorce thing. So there's no unrighteousness with God, you see. Some brothers also may think, there's this so beautiful woman but she's divorced, I can't get with her, things like that, and then they have to see what it is, but it's basically the truth. So you can't do anything against the truth, but for the truth, and it is Okay, as we were reading it, you wanna, if you are in a situation like that, you wanna find out what were the reasons why I'm divorced now. Is there a possibility that it was unrighteous? You see, things like that and whatever, you know. But it's basically your case, and you have to find out the truth about everything, basically. Okay. Okay, because nobody can change the truth, and you know, every man and woman has to find out or has to work out her or his own salvation. Okay, and this is my speaking to do. Looking for something special here. Yeah, anyway, there's a scripture talking on we can't do anything against the truth but for the truth. Okay, or maybe we can find another one. You see, Romans 2 and 2, for what if some did not believe, shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? Of course not. So let it brother give him a warning if he thinks he can do with four men that are divorced. But say it how it is adultery, okay. So if you want him, the blood is off your hands, and if you still have it, it's his thing, okay, and everybody has to work out his own salvation like he can read it, so whatever, you know. Not whatever, but you know, you can just warn, but if the people do something with it, depends on them, not on you, okay. The warning has to come from you, of course, but everybody else is not on your might, okay. It's not your power to change. So what? It's adultery, okay? And as we can know to the scriptures, not the first, but another way of adultery is, of course, this another man's woman and things like that. Okay? That's something what even as Christian, okay, knows. Okay, we've heard of course, as for what I know, there are no other ways of adultery, but the two ways to, or the two, this is adultery, okay? Both is adultery, and there is no other meaning of the word adultery, I believe. We can even prove that because if I type in here adultery. Matthew 5 and 32 is what we were reading. And then it talks about what, you know, what sin it is, it looks like that. But it never talks about something which would give another definition of adultery as we have it already. Ezekiel 16:32, but as a wife that committed adultery which taketh strangers instead of her husband. Well, you see, that's something that's natural, okay? We don't have to talk about that because first that's adultery. Yeah, come. You see, Israel committed adultery with Yahweh Shammah, which we still. Yeah, can't receive CLT, so they've got two different issues to have to go through. And then it talks about, yeah, receive clause 632, but whosoever committed adultery with a woman better than a standard, he does not be a deported. And so, yeah, that's basically with every kind of adultery that you do, it's against you also. Okay, nobody can change what you do against your own self, okay, or too positive to your own self, okay, like the other sort of apostates and so on. Though that says a man should not commit adultery, woman's to impunity, dost thou commit adultery there that applies to others, dost thou commit sickly. Yeah, exactly. So basically, like he was pointing out, there are two ways of adultery and more ways, but you know, the main two things how you would explain it to somebody are these two, and out of these two, you get everything else what we have in the scriptures here. Like I said, for adultery. Okay. Like I said, yeah. If that opposes to the other, I shall not share the